in a rage.
Oh yeah, yo, why is that, G?
Other races, they say we act like rats in a cage. I tried to argue, but check it, every night in the news, we prove them suckers right, and I got the blues.
America,
get busy, Humpty.
The red, the white, the blue, and the blue and the red for Crips and Bloods, the white for who's got you doing time, busting caps on one another.
The underground's down for peace among brothers.
Kill a black man.
What?
Yo, what are you, retarded?
Tell them, Humpty.
Yo, do you work for the Klan?
Do what you like.
Unless you like gang banging. Let's see how many brothers leave us hanging.
Do you think that Bill Cosby has been doing the black community in America a disservice for years?
I think he has. I think he, look, as an American comedian, he's a genius. One of the two or three greatest American comedians that we've ever seen, along with Richard Pryor and Mark Twain, and maybe Lenny Bruce and George Carlin. So there's no question that he's a remarkable rhetorician. There's no question that his insight as an American entertainer has been extraordinary, and his pioneering career. However, that doesn't translate into the social analysis realm. He has used his enormous wealth and his philanthropy to, I think, undermine and subvert the very practices of decency and respect to ordinary, average black people. I think he has used his bully pulpit to rain down thunder upon them, and I think he has been incredibly unfair. Let me give you one example. We were all gathered in New Orleans after Katrina, and Reverend Jesse Jackson and Reverend Al Sharpton and Mark Morial and myself were leading a march, and we spoke. Mr. Cosby spoke as well. The rest of us were saying, let's defend these people who have been dispersed. Mr. Cosby got up and said, look, you were messed up before the storm came. You were having murders before the storm came. You were having babies out of wedlock before the storm came. And he began to get on a roll of, I think, attacking defenseless people. That kind of thing is not helpful. It reinforces racist stereotypes about black people. It doesn't shed light on the persistence of structural inequalities that prevail. And it allows him to get off on poor people, which is a sport in America that I think is defenseless. And we have to indefensible,
yeah.
And we have to hold him to account and be as vigorously critical as one can imagine.
What has been your relationship with Mr. Cosby over the years, Doctor?
Look, after my book appeared, Is Bill Cosby Right or Has the Black Middle Class Lost His Mind? Predictably, Mr. Cosby did not feel very well. So I saw him in a restaurant one night, long story short, outside. He gave me the finger. The next morning, we were on a train together from New York to Washington to Philadelphia. He apologized to me, and then we had a vigorous conversation. I invited him onto my radio show. He said, I will not come on your show until you are enlightened and see the truth.
Yeah.
I think there's a kind of arrogance about Mr. Cosby that believes his way is the only way. And unfortunately, we weren't able to resolve our differences in terms of an amicable conversation, but certainly we've tried to prosecute our differences the best way we know how.
What would you tell Bill Cosby today? What would your counsel to him be?
I would say, first of all, that I hope that you would reconsider that the position you're in now, that others have felt this way for 10 years, that is to say, attacked unfairly, unjustly, assaulted, and therefore use your particular predicament now. And you are owed the presumption of innocence until guilt is proved. You are owed not to be hung by a jury in the court of public opinion. But at the same time, you are also, I think, responsible as a celebrity and a figure who is a public person to own up to discussions about issues that have been brought before us. So he's right about the media. Nobody should rush to judge him. But at the same time, I think when we consider the evidence that is weighing against him, any fair-minded person would have to say, are 20 to 25 women wrong? The same thing happened in the Catholic Church when the accusations began to mount up. Again, there's no judgment. We assume that he's innocent until proven guilty.
Okay.
But we must have a vigorous conversation. And I would say to him, own up, tell the truth. Talk about black America, talk about your particular ideas about us, and at the same time,
right,
be honest about your situation.
Dr.
You wrote a book about him. You give us that answer.
Well, 10 years ago, I did. And what was equally opprobrious to me was the kind of assaults upon poor black people, poor black women especially. All the stuff he said, you're going to have a DNA card in the ghetto pretty soon to determine if you're making love to your grandmother because you have a baby at 16. The baby has a baby when it's 16. He says, you do the math. You could be making love to your grandma. That's pretty nefarious. That's pretty problematic, but nobody cared about it. Nobody paid attention to it. And I knew I had heard some of those stories. I talked about them to a degree. So my point is that if we're going to find offense with what he said, there's so much arena there, so much area, so much real estate to talk about a bunch of stuff, including that. But Woody Allen have to be thrown in there and Roman Polanski as well.
No.
I'd like my audience to forgive me because I was laughing for a good long while before recording this episode. It's a continuation of my Goon Vision episode 24, I believe. It concerns Michael Eric Dyson and his status as a coon, a shit, and a bootlick, and an employee. A straight-up employee, man. And I found this shit out when I was recording the previous episode, but I decided that it should be its own thing, you know, because it's so goddamn funny. Because this guy spent so much time dragging Bill Cosby for, his allegations and shit, you know, which were all false and shit. Bill Cosby was innocent, okay? Now, I'm going to repeat that again. Bill Cosby was innocent. And even though he was innocent, he still did the minimum requirement of his sentence, which was 3 to 10 years and shit, okay? So anybody, you know, in you fucking head cheeses, you blue chick, checks out there, you Miss Sandra's disguised as a fake feminist and shit, you sisters out there with a stick up your ass, he did the minimum 3 years. You got 3 years of this man's life and shit, okay? But I'm not talking about Cosby right now. I'm talking about Mr. Dyson here and shit, because Mr. Dyson caught a case and shit. He caught a motherfucking case. And so, you know, ironically, he caught a case in 2020. Very similar case, he was accused of student sexual harassment and shit by one of his students there. Accused. He said that she harassed, he was accused of harassing and trying to initiate a romantic relationship with one of the students at the university he was employed at, okay? It's Georgetown, all right? Subsequently, one Crystal Fleming, who was in the opening credit scroll, accused him as well and shit. And it made me laugh my ass off about Crystal Fleming accusing him. I had to laugh so fucking hard, man. Yeah, I was laughing like 15 minutes because when you look at her, you can just see what the deal is. You can see what the deal is. Like, she's a black feminist. And more importantly, you can look right at her and you can see that she's a lesbian. But just to be fair, she was a little more feminine, I guess, when he was trying to get, trying to come at her and shit. Which explains the opening crawl and shit. But she's a butch. She's a butch. All right, I'm sorry. I hope that doesn't offend anybody in the pronoun community and shit. I'm not trying to be offensive. I'm just dragging Michael Eric Dyson because he's a boorish, hypocritical asshole and shit. And he was fucking with Cosby and shit while he had this shit on his docket. He knew what he was doing. A lot of these fucking bootlicks, man, they know they ain't getting none of their daily bread unless their white supremacist masters have some way of controlling them, making sure they stay on script and shit. And they probably knew that he had this kind of a background, that he was a you know, a horn dog and shit. And you know, this guy's supposed to be like all religious and intellectual and, you know, like a pastor and all this bullshit. And it just makes me shake my motherfucking head. This is why a lot of people are just abandoning the black church and shit in droves, because they sold us down the river and shit. We know that now. They sold us down the river. I don't know what comes next, but it ain't pretty and shit. And it definitely ain't pretty for this bootleg. You know, I hope he gets the business, all right? The Crystal Fleming is nobody you want to fuck with, man. So I laugh my fucking ass off. The students at Vanderbilt, where Dyson accepted a position in 2021, have accused the school of failing black women by hiring the alleged predator. Now I repeat that. Over at Vanderbilt, the females over there, they said the school has failed black women by hiring his monkey ass. All right, his horny ass, okay? He loved him some sisters, okay? You heard in his ignorant ass, statement directed at brothers about all the different flavors of black women and shit that's out there, but we keep eating vanilla ice cream and shit, according to him. It's always the white woman. they bring up these motherfuckers that have this Hitler youth mentality. They always talk about a fucking white woman all the time. They talk about it more than actual black dudes that dated white women and shit. Okay? You don't hear about talking about no dating no Asian women or no Spanish women or, you know, some brothers, they dating African women, you know, probably South African shit, the ones that ain't up a Zaddy's ass and shit. You don't hear him talking about that shit. No exotic chocolate or nothing. You know, Dominican or Brazilian woman. These motherfuckers got a mindset, okay? This guy is a horn dog. He's a fucking hypocrite. Not laughing my ass off because he's supposed to be so fucking smart, but he has no gaydar. And he traffics in these communities, these HBCUs and all this intellectualism and shit. He don't know. He can't tell when he's looking at a goddamn misandrist feminist and a butch lesbian, okay? They probably laughing their ass off. You probably hitting on her and shit. And then she go home strapping her girlfriend. They both laughing your ass off. They probably doing role play and shit. Like the chick, the other chick probably playing the Dyson role and shit. Man, you can't buy this kind of shit. It's fucking hilarious, man. I bet you feel stupid. Hey, man, you stupid. Okay, you stupid. You know? Fuck you. All right, don't worry. They keep putting you on. You keep popping up and shit. And it's Black History Month, so I know you'll have a little bit of work for, well, you know, the next 28 or so days. All right? Like I said before on that other episode, I'm going to say it again and shit, especially for my boy Bill Cosby and shit, okay? Who was innocent, proven innocent, after spending the minimum 3 years in prison. Just for Cosby, with Jell-O pudding pop, okay? Kiss my ass.